All right, golf fever. Now, I brought the engine blocks here inside. I have five there. This one belonged to us, no problem. One thing came and the other one there that I cannot fix it because oversized. There was also one crankshaft that was damaged. One second. So, there was one crankshaft that was have a problem, this crankshaft. You can see here the number 5 journal. Looks disaster, except for this. Here it's okay, but when you try to turn it, it's stuck. So, it's not the best thing. Anyhow, the engine block is oversized, it's more than 83 millimeters. The crankshaft is gone. This one goes back to the owner who sent us all these blocks. Then I received a couple of parts in the boxes. Fortunately, the crankshafts, they have a number. There is a number that's married to the engine. Then I see something like this. I see the oil pan. I don't think so this oil pan is gonna seal. What do you think? I think we can have a leak. So what I'm planning to do now? The parts, shit. Yeah, beautiful. All right, I'm not closing any engine. That's why the floor is also, it's not clean, it's dirty down, no problem. Okay, so that engine over there, it's the CJX. That means these are the parts from the right side here. Now, what I'm gonna do? The piston and connecting nuts and this, I'll gonna return back. Crankshaft main bearings, obviously, no, this is for the CHAs. Piston connecting nuts, I don't know what I'm gonna have inside of the boxes. I have also the three crankshafts there up, the other three down here, down there, okay. So, whatever is damaged, I'll return it back. Let us say, like the pipe that's bent, why to keep it here, right? So, piston connecting nuts, since I'm not gonna use it, I'm gonna give it back. The crankshaft rear seal, that is disaster there. It looks like that they used again, I don't know, send it back. So, I'm gonna start cleaning all the parts. Get one engine block from down there, I need a CJX. They told me that I have to close a CJX for now. I don't know if there is CHH, CJX or any other number. Crankshaft's there, so. That's the, yes, first I'm gonna see what kind of parts I have, which parts are healthy. This is why it's inside of the engine room. I have no clue. It's coming apart, this stupid thing. Yeah, tell me about it. Okay, so first I'm gonna see what kind of healthy parts I have, and then take it out, preparing to give back to the owner the old parts that I'm not gonna use it because I have no space. I do not have a space. Anyhow, that's it. Let's start. Let's find one CJX and start working on it. All right, I found one CJX. All right. Balance shaft, okay, tensioner. The bolts for the guides. There is anything here, the bolts down for the crankshaft bearing caps. Okay, I'm lucky, maybe I'm lucky, because it looks like it does have, it's not rusty. That's a good one. Not bad, not bad. Looking good. Okay, let's start with this one. Now, this is the crankshaft, because there are numbers, fortunately. That makes my life more easy. So this is what's remaining. These are the healthy parts. The piece on the connecting nuts and whatever it was broken, and the crankshaft rear seal, it's inside of these two boxes. One, two. Now this we're gonna turn back to the owner. So, yeah. Here we go again. The bore size is 83 millimeters. What I have the crankshaft, I have the engine block. I want to count how many timing chains I have and all the rest of the things, whatever I have there, because I don't think so that I have all of them. I have 1, 2, 3, four, five. No, I have all of them. Okay, yeah. Never mind. Never mind. Five. Okay. So, what I have? I have the pistons and the connecting rods, and I have the crankshaft bearing cap bolts, the side and the main down, only one set for one engine. I don't have crankshaft main bearings, connecting rod bearings, the crankshaft rear seal. What else is remaining? And it depends what other things I'm gonna see. Let's start washing and preparing it. Today it's already late actually, but anyhow, we're gonna see the progress. First wash of the engine block. Now it's time to go home. Anyhow, why I'm saying first wash. First of all, I'm not removing the freeze plugs because they look excellent. The bearings inside are okay. You can test it with a balance shaft, if, especially if you have one that does have the front piece. It's very easy to check the clearance. Anyhow, first wash, removing the sealant here down front, just clean a little bit the deck here up, and now need to be checked. Not now, tomorrow. Crankshaft it's not being washed. I just remove it from the nylon. To be standby tomorrow, we're gonna wash the crankshaft and have to be careful also with the pilot bearing here. Anyhow, where am I? Yes, so now tomorrow, taking the deck to see that it's okay, nice and flat and straight. Checking each bore. I know that they already checked it before, but now I want to double check to be okay and to be happy, to don't have any headache. It's been at 83 millimeters. Then checking the clearance on the crankshaft main bearings whenever I'm gonna receive it. And I forget something. Yes, I forget something. The most important thing. Clean the threads here for the cylinder head. Clean the threads inside, clean also the threads down on the crankshaft. And then when I see that it's okay, the deck, when I see that it's okay, the cylinder and down the crankshaft main bearings. That I have okay, that's correct the clearance. Then I'm gonna clean the threads inside, and then I'm gonna start putting parts on the engine. I remove the seal that comes here. This is for the balance shaft. Come on, yeah, it's focusing on the crankshaft. Take a look. Okay, yeah, it does know where I want to be focused. Obviously, it makes sense, right? Yeah, don't expect everything. Okay, so this point here, it's been washed, it's clean, to don't have any garbage or something. Well, we're gonna make the check, deck cylinders, crankshaft, and clean the threads, then need to be washed again for final, and then I'm gonna start putting the seal over there, put the crankshaft, main bearings, and all the rest. Well, that means we have another one day job easily here. I don't remember also if I mentioned, come on, are you kidding me now or what? Okay, I'm pointing here. It's not rusty, the engine block, so no need to be painted or something. This is something, it's on the surface, it's not something crazy. I hope with the second wash it's gonna go away. I'm talking about this one, and keep in mind, like I'm saying all the time, yeah, I can paint it. I can make it look like brand new. The color that I have, it's not exactly the same like the factory. I'm gonna spray paint it only if it has rust. You are cleaning the rust and then you're spray painting it to protect it, don't come rusty more. In this stage and in this country, as it is right now, no need to be painted. It looks okay, doesn't have any problem. And it's much better when you put on the jack or when you're opening the bonnet to see one honest engine. Because if you see an engine that has different color than the factory, then you're saying something's going on there. Anyhow, yeah, that's it. Beautiful. Nice, not bad. Tomorrow the next part. I have no clue if I have a first part or second part. Anyhow, I don't know. I'm a little bit busy with a couple of other cases here outside. And this now they told me today we receive the pieces on the connecting rods. Fix on CJX. And I have another engine here that I'm fixing right now. Anyhow, okay, it could be worse than this. Not bad, not bad. All right, That's it. That's it for today. Thank you very much. Crankshaft assembly need to be washed, the parts need to be washed, the bolts, this is back to the owner. I want to use it only to check the clearance, and then I'm going to use a new one, obviously. Balance shafts need to be washed and need to come out the carbon that has here, the burnt oil that's stuck on this, classic. This one, I have seen that before. This is the second time that I see that on the CJX-CHH. This is the cover that goes on the balance shaft, and this is supposed to be for the oil. But I don't know why. I don't know why it's going like that. I didn't even force it to come out. It was stuck, and I just made it around. Maybe from the tenor source. I don't know. Anyhow, I have another one like this from the other engine. I'm not gonna put this one because I have no clue if it starts making some sound. It shouldn't make any sound, but just in case, don't have any headache. Worst case scenario, I'm gonna get one new one, I'm gonna put it on. But I think I have. I don't think, 99% I have. Yeah, that's it. Thank you very much.